to the piece of work to be completed, the development of a multi-agency worldwide parenting strategy, and also identifies the pathways into existing services for the residents of Wirral, and that work should be carried out on a multi-agency basis in the course of that.
Thank you, Paul. Can I just ask about the Thrive model? Is that a nationally recognised?
It's an evidence-based way of working, yeah. So I don't have the exact details of how it operates, but it's an evidence-based program to support families.
The other thing I was going to say was I'm on the advisory board at Moxie Children's Centre, and I know that some of the parenting classes that are on the, obviously the younger children, they have the problems really putting in their form. But I think for older children, this is something that's really needed. Anybody?
I think this is just another example of the good work that can be done when we all come together. And then no matter where you go, we all have like a lot of involvement with Department for Education and Ofsted. And no matter where you go nowadays, it's been sort of legislation coming from government now that says that bodies have got to work together, and whether they make it or whether they don't. And I don't think people understand some of the things that are going on are underpinned by legislation saying that this is what we have to do. But I know in the work that we're doing in with Ofsted and DfE, partnership work has got to be based on how we go forward. And it's the only way forward, you know, we all have responsibility for children, we all have responsibility for anyone who's vulnerable. So it's just a really good example of the good work that this body can do, this committee can do.
Simon.
So I think I missed this when I was checking the papers, but Thrive actually stands for timely, helpful, respectful, innovative, values-based and efficient. So it's an acronym.
Thank you.
And we probably should have explained it when we put the paper together. But it's a nationally recognised approach to children and people. And I particularly welcome your support, because I think we've focused largely on older people's services and quite rightly in terms of health and care. And Paul and I met the other week, and what we're wanting to do is get more issues about children and young people on the agenda, because it's a joint strategic commissioning board for all ages. And there's a big task for Paul and his team tackling at the moment across the borough. And we all need to be behind Paul and his team and alongside them doing that. And this is just one of a good example of how we're doing that together.
That's great. Lester.
Thank you. Again, I think this is really positive and a welcomeness, because I think the more help we can offer people and parents and keen that. I do recognise that we're moving quite at some pace now in setting up the neighbourhoods as that sort of community of where care and help and support is wrapped around the people in that neighbourhood. So I suppose my ask is that when we come back with proposals, is that we've thought about particular neighbourhoods, because what we're trying to say is that one won't fit everywhere, and that each neighbourhood might have slightly different needs, so that'd be really good to link into the neighbourhoods as well.
Paul, thanks very much for presenting this, and just to sort of endorse, I think it's a real positive way forward and would support this. I particularly like the multi-agency approach, because it is the way statutory partners we do need to start working together, so absolutely welcome this. Thank you.
Anybody else? No? Councillors, are you happy to accept the recommendation set out in number 2 on page 208? Unanimous. Thank you. Government Mortimer is going to ask if